Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, students. Today I'm back with the second part of connective tissue, in which we have to discuss the classification. In today's lecture, I'll discuss the classification first, and then a little of discussion which was left regarding the extracellular matrix that we will also cover in this lecture afterwards, right? So in classification, we mainly classify connective tissue into three classes: the embryonic connective tissue, connective tissue proper, and a specialized connective tissue, right? In embryonic connective tissue, we have further two classes: the mesenchymal connective tissue and the mucoid connective tissue, right? In connective tissue proper, we have further four classes, which includes loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, reticular connective tissue, and adipose tissue. In specialized connective tissue category, we have further three classes, which includes cartilage, bone, and blood. Means bone and blood and cartilage, these are also the specialized forms of connective tissue. So these are considered under this category. These are catered in this category. So we have three categories. I repeat again: the embryonic connective tissue, connective tissue proper, and specialized connective tissue. It is better for you people that do what we used to do in our classes. Take out your notebooks, start making the notes, make this classification flowchart so that the whole classification is ready by the end of this lecture, and you people are ready for, you know, studying it and learning it. So after putting the heading of connective tissue, you will make three arrows for connective tissue: embryonic, connective tissue proper, and the connective tissue specialized. Under embryonic, write mesenchymal and mucoid. Under connective tissue proper, write loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, reticular, and adipose. It's better if you leave some spaces in front of it or below these names, so that the important features you can write just below there and then. And under specialized, write cartilage, bone, and blood. Right? Now moving to the details. For the connective tissue proper first, because out of these three categories, the embryonic, specialized, and connective tissue proper, connective tissue proper is the most important category for you people. So yeah, from examination point of view, right? So in connective tissue proper, we studied four subcategories, including loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, reticular connective tissue, and adipose connective tissue. The loose connective tissue is found widely distributed in the body. Majorly, this type of connective tissue is occupying the area of our body. It is also known as loose areolar connective tissue, right? This is the picture of loose areolar connective tissue, showing the cellular component, extracellular matrix. We can see the fibers. And these are the cells, the cellular component, right? So this picture is of loose connective tissue, also known as loose alveolar connective tissue. The second subclass in connective tissue proper is dense connective tissue. Now, dense connective tissue is again divided into two: dense irregular connective tissue and dense regular connective tissue, right? So coming back again, connective tissue proper having loose connective tissue, then dense connective tissue. Dense is further divided into dense irregular and dense regular connective tissue. Dense regular may, again, we have the collagenous type and the elastic type. The collagenous is more found in tendons, ligaments, and aponeuroses. The elastic content, the component is elastic, dense regular is found in elastic ligaments. Right, Here in this picture, we can see the dense regular and irregular. Here we can see that the arrangements of the components is in a regular pattern, and in irregular, there is the haphazard arrangement of the components of the connective tissue. So till now, we have done what? The three main categories: embryonic connective tissue proper, and specialized connective tissue. Now we are going in details of connective tissue proper, in which we have done the loose connective tissue, right? After that, we are discussing dense connective tissue here. Dense is further divided into dense irregular and regular. In this picture, we can see the regular and irregular pattern of dense regular and dense irregular connective tissue. Another picture of dense regular connective tissue, we can see the tendons and ligaments. So which type can it be? Dense regular mein humne do types padhi, kaun kaun si, recall kare. Dense regular mein we did collagenous and elastic, right? So here in this picture, which type can it be? Tendons हैं, ligaments हैं, aponeurosis अगर दिखाया तो this is the collagenous dense regular connective tissue, right? So here in this picture, again we can see dense regular, dense irregular and elastic, अभी हम आगे करेंगे, right? Okay, now the reticular connective tissue, the third subclass of connective tissue proper. In this, we will find the reticular fibers, which are formed of collagen type 3, okay, and the reticular cells, which are the variety of fibroblast, right? Fibroblast, we have already discussed this in the cellular component of connective tissue, if you remember, okay? And fibers, maybe these reticular fibers have been discussed in the extracellular matrix part, right? So this is the reticular connective tissue. This is how it looks like. These are the reticular fibers, the dark fibers. Then the fourth sub variety of connective tissue proper is adipose tissue. Adipose means fatty tissue, right? So fat cells mein bhi humne ye baat ki thi ki wo white bhi hote hain, brown bhi hote hain. So white adipose tissue, usually हमें adults में ज़्यादा white tissue मिलता है, fetus और newborns में हमें brown adipose ज़्यादा मिलता है. And the difference at microscopic level, how will you differentiate? Brown adipose is multilocular, white adipose is unilocular. Now just take your time and recall the name of this unilocular. What did I tell you in the last lecture? Which characteristic appearance does it show? Okay, so for them who said signet ring appearance, this is correct. The characteristic signet ring appearance is there for the unilocular white adipose cell, right? It is the single cell. Ek hi isme hame locule milna hai, pura beech mein lipid droplet hota hai, jo ki on staining it fades out, right? Yahan hame empty block milta hai, and the nucleus is on the periphery, single nucleus. So it looks like a single stone ring, jisko hum kehte hain signet ring appearance, signet ring cell. So these are three pictures in which we can see the areolar tissue, which is loose areolar tissue, the adipose tissue. This is how the fat cells will look like. Reticular tissue, iski histological slides mein you will be able to see the dark reticular fibers jisko distinguish kar rahe honge. And then the dense tissue, dense ki picture would be more like this. Aur aapki abhi practical ki jo abhi class hogi, usme you will be shown more histological pictures. So you can be able to distinguish one from the other, right? This is dense. So we did four subclasses in this, which were they? Let's repeat it again. These were the four classes: the loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue, reticular and adipose, right? let's move forward. Coming to the connective tissue, embryonic, further divided into mesenchymal and mucoid, right? Now, as the name says, mesenchymal, ये हमें developing embryo में मिलेगा, ठीक है? Mesenchymal cells होंगे, reticular fibers होंगे, इसके components में, right? So, developing embryo will be having the mesenchymal embryonic connective tissue. Mucoid connective tissue हमें mucus-like tissue होता है, जिसमें fibroblast-like cells होंगे, collagen type 1 and type 3 fibers होंगे, collagen types अभी हम आगे discuss करेंगे. I have a slide for you people. राइट इसकी एग्जांपल्स में हमारे पास है अम्ब्लाइकल कॉर्ड के अराउंड. आप सब ने देखा होगा इन अ न्यूबॉर्न बेबी द अम्ब्लाइकल कॉर्ड इज हैविंग अ जिलेटिनस मटेरियल अराउंड इट राइट नोन एज वॉटन्स जेली. सो दिस इज एक्चुअली द म्यूकॉइड एम्ब्रियोनिक टिश्यू एम्ब्रियोनिक कनेक्टिव टिश्यू राइट. सो द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ म्यूकॉइड विल बी वॉटन्स जेली एंड इन मेसेनकाइमल दैट इज फाउंड इन द डिवेलपिंग एम्ब्रियो. This is the Wharton's jelly. You all of you must have seen this. Okay, so this was the classification of connective tissue. उसके बाद bone का आप अलग से एक detail lecture होगा. Blood पे अलग से आपका एक lecture blood module में होगा. So they don't need any discussion. And cartilage that will be covered as a separate component in this module, right? Now we'll discuss a little about extracellular matrix. Extracellular matrix mein we studied the connective tissue fibers and the ground substance, right? For the connective tissue fibers, we have three kinds of fibers: the collagen fibers, reticular fibers, and elastic fibers. For the collagen fibers, mainly predominant collagen type 1 is helpful in making them. In the reticular fibers, protein collagen type 3 is there for their makeup, and elastic fibers may protein elastin will be helpful, right? So collagen fibers type 1 collagen se bante hain, reticular fibers made up of collagen type 3, and elastic fibers are by protein elastin, right? In the connective tissue fibers, we can see collagen fibers, reticular fibers, and elastic fibers. जो अभी हमने बात की है ये तीनों types, right? और इन्हीं तीनों types के आगे proteins and a little details. Collagen fibers are non-branched fibers arranged found in bundles. ठीक है? These are acidophilic fibers. Reticular fibers, they form a network. They are stained black with silver stain. ठीक है? Normally ये H&E पे हमें इतने proper नहीं दिखेंगे. ये silver stain हम जब देंगे slide को तो उसमें हमें ये black threads दिख रहे होते हैं reticular fibers. The elastic fibers, they are branched like these and they are stained brown with orsine stain. Let's move forward. So in this picture, we can see the elastic fibers highly branched, the collagen fibers, reticular are not seen in these, but you can see the difference in the thickness of collagen and elastic fibers. Again, a picture showing the collagen fibers, dark pink, acidophilic, reticular fibers, and the elastic fibers, right? This is the picture of elastic reticular fibers. This is not reticular fiber, right? Reticular appear like this. That picture is not correct. ठीक है? It appears like this. Let's move forward. Now a little detail of collagen fibers. Collagen, it's a flexible but tough fiber which is found in almost every organ. right, for the strength of every organ. Obviously, it's a structural framework, so it is needed by each and every tissue of the body. So collagen fibers made up of number of units called fibrils. जिस तरह हमने muscle में पढ़ा है, myofibrils होते हैं, filaments होते हैं, and then the muscle fiber is made up, right? Likewise, इसमें भी fibrils होते हैं जो कि collagen fibers बनाते हैं फिर आगे जाके bundle up होके. Collagen is the major insoluble fibrous protein in the extracellular matrix. And in fact, it is the single most abundant protein in the connective tissue, right? So it is the most important constituent of connective tissue. In this picture, you can see the bundle of collagen fibers. ये fibers का एक bundle है, ये पूरे एक एक fiber है, और fiber के अंदर ये fibrils हैं, ठीक है? Remember, हमने muscle में भी ऐसी एक picture देखी थी. So this is how it is arranged in bundles. It appears white in unstained sections and they are formed by the polymerization of protein called collagen. This we all know. Collagen has the high affinity for acidophilic dye, so that's why they appear more darker in the stains. They stain blue in Mallory and green in Mason stain. And they act as a glue for the structure, for any of the structure or organ which is having collagen in its connective tissue. So it will be acting as a glue in nature. Glue hoga to usse kya fayda hoga, jo uske saath sara uska matrix hai, jo structural framework hai, that will be sticked to it on its surface, right? Collagen ko agar hum boil karte hain to they give the gelatinous look like this. राइट, कोएगुलेशन वाली लुक आ जाएगी इसकी. कोलेजन प्रोटीन इज ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स, टिपिकली गिव 65 नैनोमीटर क्रॉस बैंडिंग्स. इट हैज अप टू 20 टाइप्स ऑफ कोलेजन. वी हैव कोलेजन प्रोटीन्स की 20 टाइप्स हमारे पास हैं, बट अमंग्स दोस फर्स्ट 5 आर वेरी numerous in our body, and first 5 are normally asked, rather first 4 are normally asked, or type 1 is forming the collagen fibers. Type 2 is normally present in cartilages, that you will discuss, that you will be taught in the cartilage section, jab cartilage aapko padhayenge. Type 3 is mainly found in reticular fibers, and type 4 is present mainly in basement membrane. Iske alawa aur kahan kya pe present hai, I have a chart for you people in the upcoming slides, I'll show you up, right? So another picture for the collagen bands. Theek hai, ye bands hai. See, these types of collagen, type 1, type 2, 3, 4, 5 and 7. ज़्यादातर आपसे 5 पूछी जाती हैं, कौन से cells इसको synthesize कर रहे हैं, and major locations of the body. It is mentioned in this chart. This chart is very useful, so it's better you copy it down or have the screenshot of this, right? This is the picture of reticular fibers in the lymph node. The elastic fibers, also known as yellow fibers, these are the bundles of protein elastin. We have already discussed. Collagen fibers, type 1 collagen banayega. Reticular fibers made up of collagen type 3. Elastic fibers made up of protein elastin. Right? Achha, ye protein kahan se produce ho rahe? By fibroblasts and smooth muscle cells in arteries. Fibers can stretch up to 1.5 times their length, and they snap back to their original length when relaxed, right? So when they are in a stretched stage, wo jo hai apne length se 1.5 times greater stretch up ho sakte hai. Elastic naam hi isliye hai unka. And when they are relaxed, un pe koi strain nahi hai, they are back to their normal position. Theek hai, jis tarah aap ek rubber band ko stretch karte hain aur usko chhodte hain, to wo back to its normal length aa jata hai. Elastic fibers include elastin, alanin and oxytalin. Elastin is important for you people. Alanin and oxytalin pata hone chahiye naam, but to remember is elastin. Elastin is important. ठीक है. हेयर इन दिस पिक्चर वी कैन सी द इलास्टिक एबिलिटी ऑफ दिस इलास्टिक फाइबर्स. दिस इज द रिलैक्स स्टेज ऊपर वाली एंड द नीचे वाली इज द स्ट्रेच्ड स्टेट. तो दिस इज हाउ इट कैन स्ट्रेच टू द लॉन्गर लेंस 1.5 टाइम्स ग्रेटर टू इट्स ओरिजिनल एंड देन रिकॉइल टू इट्स बैक टू इट्स नॉर्मल. So again the picture for comparison, the collagen fibers thicker and the elastic fibers thinner and highly branched. So that was all about fibers. In ground substance we have glycosaminoglycans, proteoglycans and glycoproteins. In glycosaminoglycans, only also known as GAGs, G-A-G-S, we have these substances, chondroitin sulfate, dermatin sulfate, keratin sulfate, heparin sulfate, hyaluronic acid and heparin. Naam pata hone chahiye aur kahan kahan pe ye localize kar rahe hain, locations. Not very important, but you must give a read to it. But at least you should know the names of GAGs, right? This is how the proteoglycans, they covalently attach with the GAGs, right? These are the GAGs. Sahi proteoglycans ka function kya hoga? These are the proteins that are covalently attached to one or more glycosaminoglycan chains, right? This is the proteoglycan chain. Sahi hai? Iske around you can see ke kitne sare GAGs aake jud gaye. Aur phir ye proteoglycan jaake मेन स्पिलेटेक स्ट्रैंड. तो प्रोटियोग्लाइकेंस का हो गया काम कि ये इट विल एक्ट एज अ चेन फॉर द अटैचमेंट ऑफ डिफरेंट गैग्स ऑन इट, राइट. देन ग्लाइकोप्रोटीन्स, दीज आर द प्रोटीन्स दैट कंटेन्ड ओलिगोसैकेराइड्स. They covalently attach to polypeptide side chains. The carbohydrates attach to the protein in the co-translational and post-translational modifications. The major types of adhesive glycoproteins are fibronectin, laminin and entectin. For you people, here co-translation and post-translation modification is not important. So for you people, you just need to know the names. The fibronectin, laminin and entectin, these are the glycoproteins which are helpful. ठीक है. और इसका function क्या होगा? ये adhesive glycoproteins हैं. ठीक है. ये adhere कर रहे होते हैं. किसी भी complex of proteins को लेके adhere कर रहे होंगे. Right? So we have this laminin, we have the fibronectin. ठीक है. तो दिस इज एक्चुअली द एडहेसिव प्रोटीन्स. सो दिस वॉज ऑल फॉर टूडेज लेक्चर इन विच वी डिस्कस द क्लासिफिकेशन, राइट. क्लासिफिकेशन में वी डिड थ्री मेजर कैटेगरीज, द एम्ब्रियोनिक कनेक्टिव टिश्यू, कनेक्टिव टिश्यू प्रॉपर एंड स्पेशलाइज कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. एम्ब्रियोनिक में वी डिड द मेसेनकाइमल एंड द म्यूकॉइड. स्पेशलाइज विल बी कवर्ड इन एज अ डिफरेंट लेक्चर इट्सेल्फ. कार्टिलेज अलग कराया जाएगा, बोन अलग कराया जाएगा, ब्लड जो है आपका अलग कराया जाएगा. देन इन कनेक्टिव टिश्यू प्रॉपर वी डिड लूज कनेक्टिव टिश्यू, डेंस कनेक्टिव टिश्यू, एडिपोज एंड रेटिकुलर. एंड इन डेंस वी डिड डेंस रेगुलर एंड डेंस इरेगुलर. And dense regular was further into two types, the collagenous and the elastic, right? So it's better you make the classification chart in your notebooks. You have to copy this chart in your books. The collagen fibers, these are very important, the types and their location. This chart is very important. Rather than that, you can add the add into your notes regarding the names only of glycosaminoglycans, proteoglycans and glycoproteins. Only the names are important in that. For fibers, you need to know the names. Along with that, you need to know the types of collagen and the location. Right? For any queries, you can email that to me on dr.sahrish@gmail.com. It's dr.sahrish, dr.sahrish@gmail.com, right? If there are any queries, you can email to me and I'll be more than happy to answer for your queries, right? Till then, Allah Hafiz. Take care.